الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي رب زدني علما. Honorable Principal Dr. Muhammad Sariful Islam, respected teachers, elders, Honorable Judge, dear conveners, guardians, my classmates, and my dear brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today, I will talk about education in Islam. Islam is our greatest gift. We have to be thankful for this gift. We have to render to due Allah. Allah has given us so much by making us a part of the Ummah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we must totally commit ourselves as a Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We must become true Muslims. Now, how can we become Muslims in the true sense of the words? A Muslim is a Muslim because he is a follower of Islam, a submitted to the will of Allah. No man become truly a Muslim without knowing the meaning of Islam. Because he become Muslim not through birth but through knowledge. Unless we come to know the basic and necessary teaching of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how can we believe and have faith in him? Without education, one cannot truly receive Allah's gift. If our knowledge is little, then we will constantly run the risk of losing that magnificent gift which we received. A person without education is like someone walking a track in complete darkness. Most likely, his step will wander aside, and he easily can be deceived by deceiver or Satan. We shall also be able to identify and avoid the dangerous path of kufr, shirk, and immorality, which may cross it. Islam places great stress when seeking knowledge and education. Generally speaking, one man have right path in this world. This is true in all times and places. Education is very important in human's life. It makes a man right thinker. No one can think properly without having a fair amount of knowledge. It helps the man to take the right decision. In fact, Islam called upon seeking out knowledge on all level. The first word revealed of the Quran to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was Iqra, read. Seek knowledge, educate yourself, be educated, which highlights the importance of education. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Talabul ilmi faridatun ala kulli muslimin." Seeking knowledge is compulsory on every Muslims. And he also said, "Man salaka tariqan yaltamisu bihi ilman sahalallahu lahu bihi tariqan ilal jannah." Whoever follows a path seeking knowledge, Allah will make his path to paradise. In Islam, education process derives its pillar from Holy Quran and prophetic tradition, companions, followers, and opinions of pedagogy scholars. Education and knowledge is mandatory upon both men and women in Islam. Allah said in the Holy Quran, "Kul hal yastawi alladhina ya'lamuna walladhina la ya'lamun." Are those equal, those who know and those who do not know? And also said, "Yutil hikmata man yasha'u wa man yutil hikmata faqad utiya khayran katheera." Allah grants wisdom to whom He pleases, and to whom wisdom is granted, indeed he receives an ever following benefits. Our mission: Islam is a school, Deen is a class, Dunya is a campus, we are a student. Quran is a syllabus, Ramzan is a test, Namaz is a practical. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a teacher, and Qiyamah is a date of result. So try to get first position and admission to Jannah. And last, I pray to Allah, may Allah give us strength and power of education. O Lord, increase ana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.